Good morning, student. Today I am explain about the electric potential due to a point charge. So potential due to a point charge, first you take a point charge plus Q, and around that charge electric field is there. In that you are taken a point A at a distance R. Now to that point A, you are bringing another unit positive charge, that is plus 1, at a point P in an electric field. The distance between plus Q and the unit positive charge is X, okay, as shown in the figure. Now, by Coulomb's force, the repulsion between plus Q and plus 1, that is plus 1 is unit charge, is given by, according to the Newton's law of Coulomb. So you know that force between the two charges must be F is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by D square, or X square. So here Q1 must be you are taken plus Q, Q2 must be you are taken plus 1. Therefore F is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 1 divided by X square. So then F is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by X square. This equation must be comes from Coulomb's law. Then let a unit positive charge be displaced towards plus Q charge. अब क्या करो, अब unit positive charge जो है ना displace करो, move करो, किधर move करना, plus Q charge के तरफ. So that is dx is displacing positive charge, then work done W is equal to, or dW is equal to. So you know that about the, suppose एक point charge जो है एक place से दूसरा place को आप लेके जा रहे समझो, तो work has to be done. Then W is equal to what happen? Force into the displacement. So F into S. So here in this, dW is equal to, force is F and the displacement is dx. Then dW is equal to F into dx cos theta. So why we are taken cos theta? Force is the vector form, dx is also in the vector form. The dot product of the vector must be, that is fx cos theta. Instead of fx cos theta, you are taken F dx cos theta. Now theta must be here how much degree? That is 180 degree. Then cos 180 degree must be equal to minus 1. Therefore the minus sign comes in the below equation. dW is equal to minus F into dx. Now using the above equation, we can write dW is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by X square into dx. Okay. Let the unit positive charge be displaced from infinity. पहले क्या करे थे, एक distance dx से लिए थे, अब infinity से जो है ना एक charge को जो है displace करो. कहाँ तक displace करना? To a point A. You observe the figure also. Now from x is equal to infinity to x is equal to, it is R. The total work done can be calculated by integrating the above equation between the limits x is equal to infinity to x is equal to, it is R. So now integration about dW is equal to integration of x is equal to infinity to x is equal to R, that is minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught X square into dx. So constant term must be taken outside of the integration. W is equal to integration of dW is equal to W. So W is equal to minus 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into integration infinity to R X to the power of minus 2 into dx. So now you apply here integration. So what happens? Minus Q by 4 pi epsilon naught as it is. So you solve the integration of that X square is equal to X to the power of 2 plus 1 divided by 2 plus 1, it is formula. That's why X to the power of minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1 infinity to R. So rearrange to this one, or calculate minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught X to the power of minus 1 divided by minus 1, that is infinity to R. That is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by X infinity to, it is R. Now you put the values. So q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by r minus 1 by infinity. So then 1 by infinity is equal to 0. Therefore 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught q divided by r it is. Now this work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to a given point in the electric field of source charge equal to electric potential due to the source charge at the point, that is W is equal to V. The above equation becomes V is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R. So, thank you.